My name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to another video of mine about industrial design. I needed to create a hot shoe mount for my Joby GorillaPod so that I could use the same system on my tripod and my various other rigs when I record videos for YouTube. This is going to show you how to make a quality two-part silicone mold of anything. This just happens to be what I used, this little hot shoe mount adapter. It has undercuts, it has threads, it has some pretty difficult stuff that would be impossible to do with a rigid type mold, but with silicone, it's no problem. I create a basic mold box and a base that I'm going to mount my part on to make the first half of the silicone mold. Here I'm just making some little sprues and gates for me to pour the resin in eventually. I need to have those cavities mapped out. You'll see I'm notching the little parts here, so that way when they're cast in resin later on, they can just snap off really easy. I'm adding a little bit of clay right here to increase the area, volume area where I'm going to inject or pour in the resin later on. I'm making sure to use a clay that is non-sulfur based, and the reason for this is so that the silicone will cure. Many silicones will not cure against sulfur-based clay, so make sure that you watch out what kind of a clay you're using so you don't have any issues later on when you're casting. I put a little ring of clay around my part, and then I squeeze it into my mold box, my pre-made mold box of 3/4-inch plywood. I screw it all together so that I can reuse it later on or for any other project that I'm using. I get the clay, it squeezes out here a little bit, and I go in with my clay tool and I go all the way around the edge and I pull out that excess clay so I have a really nice cast part. Once the part's in the mold box ready to go, it's time to pour in some silicone to make the first half of the silicone mold. I'm actually casting some other pieces in the background there, so I'm mixing up way more silicone than you would normally need for a project like this. But it was shot at the same time, so you'll have to excuse the additional silicone. You wouldn't need that much for this. I'm using a GI-1040, pretty standard silicone. I get this from Innovative Polymers. It's made by Silicone Inc. Great stuff. I use it for almost all of my projects. Degassing it in the vacuum tank, and I have to let the air off every once in a while. I have a lot of silicone in this container, and I can't just pull it all at once, or it'll overflow the top, so I have to continuously pull the vacuum, let the air out to try to degas the silicone. Degassing the silicone is important so that you don't get any air bubbles in your part, and also for when the silicone goes into a pressure tank later on. If you have air bubbles in your silicone, you will get, your part will have like what's called the measles, and you will get little bumps in your part. So it's important to degas your silicone if you're gonna make a high quality resin bubble free part later on. So the silicone's been degassed, and I put a little bit of silicone in the very middle where I have some threads, and I allow the silicone to flow in there, and I even get in there with a little stick. I need to make sure that there is no air inside of there or trapped in there. So I let the silicone flow in there really good. Then I pour in the silicone, and I pour it in from one side, and I pour the silicone on top of itself and let the silicone flow out into the mold. This is important to reduce the amount of air bubbles that you have on your part. Once the silicone cures overnight, I take the mold box from around the silicone apart and I start to demold. Here I'm just trimming off the little corners just to make the silicone nice and neat, as I like to do that. Now, ideally, when you're casting a two-part silicone mold, you don't want to take your part out of the first silicone piece that you cast. And the reason for that is you can introduce error. In this case, the part has a very soft curve at the bottom. And I had a tiny little bit of silicone that creeped under the part, and I needed to trim it up a little bit. So normally you'd want to keep it inside. It was unavoidable in this case. I'm trimming off these little excess parts so I have a nice clean part line for later. I place the part back in the silicone and I'm applying some Vaseline that's been thinned down with naphtha here. And this becomes my release agent, because silicone only pretty much sticks to silicone, and you want to make sure that your second half of your mold doesn't stick to the first half, or it's really not going to work out for you. I'm mixing up some more silicone, similar to what I did before. Silicone, adding in the activator right here. It's going to go into the vacuum tank. I'm going to degas it so I have bubble-free silicone to cast onto the back side. Make sure you mix up your silicone really, really well, scraping the sides of the cup and not leaving any unmixed silicone inside of that cup. It is super important to do that so that you get a nice, consistent silicone to pour into your mold box to make an excellent part. Because the last thing you want to do is all this prep work and then have silicone that's not mixed up, and then you get a bad part. Here again, just degassing it. Of course, my container's not big enough, so I have to be careful so that don't get silicone all over my vacuum tank. I'd say after about 15 minutes, all the air is evacuated from the silicone. You can see there's very few bubbles left popping here. Pour some silicone into my part, again into that middle cavity, to make sure that silicone flows out really nice and I'm not getting any air bubbles trapped in those undercuts right there. Once that's done, and I let that set for a few minutes, and I'm coming in and I'm pouring in the rest of the silicone for the rest of my two-part mold. Here I am demolding. Comes apart nice. There's no issues. I'm basically just dealing with the undercuts on the part. Tiny little bit of silicone right there, but I was lucky and it came apart. There it is, two-part mold. Watch my next video. It's going to show the casting of this part, mixing up the resin, degassing that, and making some parts. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel below. You can also follow me on Twitter, where I'm tweeting about products on this planet and different projects that I'm working on. You can also go to the Botson website and sign up for the newsletter and get occasional updates about the different projects that I'm working on. Feel free to share this video on your favorite social media site and let your friends know about it. Rock on!